So in the previous two videos, we discussed the bound states and the scattering states for the delta potential well. Now it's time to take a quick look at another case that is very similar, which is the delta potential barrier. Now, this case is where there is a similar potential, except that this time, instead of a minus sign in front, there's going to be a plus sign in front. So if you graph this, it's going to be basically the same, except that this time the delta potential will be going up instead of down. So this is already going to be, maybe you already have this intuition, maybe you have seen this before, but this means that when we take a look at the bound state, which is actually the first thing that we will do, here there will always be some energy in the negative region. And our potential is either zero, which is greater than something negative, or this infinite amount at x equals zero, which is also greater than something negative. So basically, in this case, our bound state means that the energy will always be less than the potential. Now, the thing is, what does this mean? So let us take a look at that. So bound states means energy less than zero. Let's take a quick look at the Schrödinger equation for some general potential. There's no need to go to this specific case because, as we will see, the argument works for any potential. This is equal to E psi. So as we have done many times, let's just write this second derivative here by itself. So we get E, actually let me write like this. So we get minus 2m divided by h bar squared factor of E minus V times psi. We can just take this minus sign and put it in here. So we get plus 2m here and V minus E. So this quantity right here is always going to be positive. Why? Because our energy is positive, our potential here is positive. So our energy is negative, but it has this minus sign in front. So we are going to get minus a negative number, which is going to be a positive number. So that means that this entire constant right here will always be positive. So just for simplicity, let's just call it, let's say, k squared, as we usually do. So this means that the second derivative of our wave function will always have the same sign as the wave function, right? Because this here is just some positive constant. It doesn't change anything in terms of the sign. So what does this mean? So let's just take a look at, let's graph. So let's just say we have some wave function. If this wave function is positive, then what we just saw tells us that the second derivative will have the same sign. So if the wave function is positive, then the second derivative is positive. So that means that our wave function will be concave upwards. Right? The exact form may vary, but it will be concave upwards. And if the wave function is negative in some region, then that just means that the second derivative will also be negative. So what this means is that there is no possibility for either, for any wave function of this form to go to zero as x goes to plus or minus infinity. So that means that no wave functions that satisfy this relationship can be physically realizable states. And with this, we can conclude that for the delta potential barrier, there are no bound states. Actually, yes, it looks like something else, but no bound states, okay. So no bound states for the delta potential barrier. Okay, so what about scattering states? Let's see that. So scattering states. So in this case, we would have to do exactly the same procedure that we did in the last video, which if you want, you are welcome to do. But as you will remember, both our R coefficient and T depended not on this value of alpha, but on alpha squared. So this means that this minus sign or plus sign do not really change the result. So we could just do this again, but it's done in the previous video and the procedure is exactly the same. You will get exactly the same result, which is actually quite interesting because this means that a particle has the same probability of being transmitted or reflected across a potential barrier than it would across a well, which is kind of weird if you think about it classically, because if you are driving some car and you come across some potential well, which maybe just some hole, you don't expect the car to come across this hole and then just bounce back, right? But that is something that can happen in quantum mechanics. So that is this case for scattering states. As I said, it's a lot easier than the previous case. The bound states do not exist. Scattering states are exactly the same as in the delta potential. Well, and that is also actually why most textbooks don't really talk much about the delta potential barrier. And that's why I wanted to dedicate a video to this, because I had thought about this when I was studying this for the first time, and I had a really tough time finding any videos or books that paid any attention to this. So this is why. So I hope you enjoyed this. I will see you in the next video.